Accurate stuff, Jim, believe me.
All right, we know it's pretty common to train a horse or a dog.
There we go. What was that?
Come on in.
What was that, Nick?
There we go. He's just shaking his head. Speaking of training, it's not common to train crocodiles or alligators. At least I don't think so.
No, it's not. Croc and gator training is risky stuff, but croc handlers do it for good reason. So ABC7's Kristen Clark went to Gatorama, the only breeding colony of American crocs.
Everything I do with these animals is a calculated risk.
He's fine.
I've got about 15 or 20 large alligators in this pond behind me that are trained.
Come on, alligators, let's go.
They know their names.
All right, good boy, Ben.
And one at a time, I can call them out of the water so that we can deal with that one individual.
There are people who work with alligators and crocodiles every day.
I'm working on a trust with the animal, and I build up that trust.
If you've ever wondered where all the zoos and attractions get their gators, it's from places like Gatorama.
Gatorama is home to the only breeding colony of American crocodiles in the United States. We've got over 30 breeding crocodiles here.
And when dealing with so many crocs and gators, it makes their lives much easier to train them.
When we need to move an animal, to check it for a vet check.
If he's got any injuries to him, we can touch him, right? Good boy.
It's a lot easier to call a 700-800 pound alligator or crocodile to you than it is to try and throw a rope on it and fight it and pull it to where you need it to go.
Now, crocs and gators are two totally different reptiles, so training them is different too.
The crocodiles tend to be a little smarter, so once they do pick up the training, they pick it up quicker, but at the same time, because they're a little smarter, it's harder to gain their trust.
Good girl.
They are much more nervous. They don't trust us like the alligators. I kind of, with these two species, the alligators to me are kind of like dogs. If you have food, they're and they just get right in your lap. And the crocodiles are more like a cat. They're like, I don't know yet. You got to kind of do this on my terms. But once they figure it out, what you can do with these guys is amazing.
Especially since these reptiles are so powerful. Considering they have a brain the size of a walnut, and the force of their chomp can be over 3,000 pounds. But they're able to train them by using positive reinforcement.
We use verbal cues, we use visual cues, but the main thing that apex predators react to is a food reward. So we have our reward system is basically three tiers. The top tier is food. That's what they want more than anything. The second tier is positive reinforcement by touch, by rubbing the alligator and reinforcing that he's done something good. And then the third would be the tone of our voice. We can either have a positive tone or we can have a negative tone with those animals. So with the alligators, the touch part gets a little touchy because they don't, by instinct, like to be touched.
So, in case you were wondering, here's how to train an alligator.
Before I trusted any of these alligators, I stuck my hand down there and we targeted the alligators to the stick. So what we would do is put the stick in the water and they would bring their nose to the stick and then they would get fed.
So the first thing we have to do is kind of desensitize them to our touching and then get them to realize that it's positive. Once we do that, the alligator no longer sees us as a threat and they don't see us as food. They see us as the source of food because they're coming up to eat. But at that point, they're not trying to eat us. They don't want to eat us. They want the food that we're providing for them.
They make it look so easy, but it isn't safe, and trainers know that.
Here comes one on Alan's right.
If my hand ends up in his mouth, he's keeping it. He doesn't realize, oh, this is the keeper that I've been dealing with. They don't have that level of consciousness.
Yeah, it sounds crazy, but that's because we simply fear what we don't understand. Croc handlers are helping us learn so much about these creatures. It's way more than entertainment. It's educational, and it gives people a chance to understand these two native species.
Yeah, that's amazing.
That is incredible. So shout out to Kristen and Ryan. My gosh.
Yeah, hope nobody whew. Loses their hand.
Our photographer got some amazing shots there. Ryan Collins, good job. As a reminder, training alligators is for professionals only. It's also illegal in Florida to handle or interact with gators unless you are at a zoo or a place like Gatorama. Do not feed wild gators.
No.
Leave them alone. They are surely experts there, so this is not something you attempt in your backyard.
I have one in my bag.
Yeah, I mean, many of us do.
I keep my distance.
On water.
I keep my distance.
Good idea.
Yeah.
All right, our time right now is 9:22. We're going to be right back.